Okay, I've been trying to complete the video on the power turbine for about a year, and it's very difficult to do because they're rare, they're elusive, and they reside in places that are difficult to get to. So I've only got a little bit of footage. I'll put it all together for you, but what I'm going to do is resort to something I've never done before, and that is a blackboard drawing to show you, a whiteboard drawing, to show you what a power turbine is and how it works. So let's draw that out. Our most common engine is the LM1500, which I'm going to draw the basics of right here. LM1500. It's got a compressor with 15 stages of compression. I won't draw them all. It's got a combustion area. Okay. And the compressor is connected directly by a shaft to a three-stage turbine. Now there's a coupling in the middle to allow for thermal expansion, but this turbine, the mechanical power, is extracted from the combustion gases, and its only purpose is to provide torque to turn the compressor to bring the air in and to compress it. And then it can be burned in the combustion chambers. The power turbine is right there, and it's got either one or two stages. I'm going to draw a single stage for simplicity here. It's got a great big shaft coming out of it. Now this shaft has a great deal of torque on it. The residual energy from the exhaust gases from the 1500 are, let's see, this thing's in the way. We've got a connection there. This is a duct. And this is, let's say, that's where the power turbine starts. This can drive your load about 15,000 horsepower. It's commonly used as a straight shaft. Also, it can enter a gearbox, a reduction or a speed increasing gearbox, which has an output. Now, in one particular application, the LM1500 spins at 7200 RPM. The power turbine spins at 5500 RPM. And this output of the gearbox spins at 12,500 RPM. Okay, the one thing that a lot of people ask about is this connection here, right there, between the LM1500 gas generator and the power turbine. What's in there? And the answer is nothing. It's hot exhaust gases blowing through a steel tube into the power turbine. There is no mechanical connection here. This would be the LM1500. This would be the duct. And this would be the power turbine, or PT for short. This here would be the gearbox, if it's used. And then over here would be the load. In this particular situation, the load is a centrifugal compressor of natural gas in a pipeline, but it could also be an electrical generator. Many times the power turbine is designed to spin at 3600 RPM. There are other engines that spin at 8000 RPM or lower or higher, and I've been asked, how does that generate electricity at 3600 RPM? The answer is right in here. In the coupling between the power turbine and the engine, it's only hot air, so they both turn at their own best speeds. There is no gearbox, there's no linkage, there's no coupling, there's no U-joint, there's nothing. And it does work. Okay, here's another example. We've got a Rolls-Royce Avon, uses a gas generator. It also has 17 stages of compression leading to a combustion area. And it has a three-stage turbine connected by a shaft. and of course the coupling, which allows thermal expansion of the engine. The power turbine is, there are various manufacturers. This is a two-stage PT, and it turns at 3,600 RPM. Oops. 3,600 RPM. All right. And that, in turn, directly drives an electrical generator, which produces about 8 megawatts of power. So, I've been asked before, how does an 8,000 RPM engine get geared down to 3,600 RPM? Well, again, in this duct, there is nothing. There is hot air at pressure. I'm not sure exactly what the pressure is, probably around 50 PSI. And it turns this power turbine. Now, this power turbine is designed to run at its best, most economical speed at its rated output at 3,600 RPM through the magic of aerodynamics. Don't ask me how it's done. Anyway, this spins at 8,000, produces a massive quantity of hot gases flowing in the rearward direction, drives this power turbine at 3,600 RPM, driving the electrical generator, where you have your 8 megawatts of AC to feed into the grid. We're looking at the blades of a single stage LM1500 power turbine, which is a separate piece of equipment in the installation. There's the main output shaft, which would drive the load. That might be a gas compressor or a electrical generator or even the propeller of a ship. And this one's been taken apart for some parts donation. These are the turbine tip shrouds. They're in pretty good shape, but there's been a bit of a rub there. Not too bad though. This thing's a bit rusty because it's been retired. Now this here is the inlet to the power turbine for a Rolls-Royce Spey, which is about the same horsepower, maybe a bit more horsepower than a 1500. And I'm going to pan up to the side first and up, so you can see the size of the exhaust duct. It's very large because it's designed to remove any residual thrust and to carry away the exhaust gases, usually to a silencer, to eliminate the noise. This is typical of a stationary installation, which would be used to run a generator or perhaps a gas compressor on a pipeline. And the output of the power turbine, the shaft's torque, would be fed into, typically through a coupling like this, into a large gearbox, and here's one. Let's take a look at it. Has an output for the load, the mechanical load right there. Now, let's take a look at the data plate of this gearbox. All right, so it says its input RPM is 5429. Service horsepower is 15,000 horsepower. The output RPM is 3,600, so it may have been used to generate electricity. And let's put this together with some footage of a couple of power turbines. I have a footage of me deblading a two-stage, the first stage of a two-stage power turbine. Okay, now we're gonna knock the pin through. And that's how the blades are locked in. Now they can all come out. Okay. Now we're gonna knock these blades out of the wheel. They're not exactly tight. It's a very close fit. So we have to apply a small amount of persuasion. We'll go all the way around this wheel a couple of times and they'll all just fall out. Of course, we're using an aluminum drift, which protects the steel of the turbine from any damage. You never hit it directly with the hammer. Just about there. There you go. There, now we've got to get this wire out of here. My instructors at BCIT, Jerome, Brian, and Grant, who said you'd never find a hammer near a turbine engine, well, you'd have to say almost never.
fully de-bladed. That's a pretty beefy piece of equipment. The first stage turbine wheel from a LM1500 power turbine. It's much larger than the actual turbine of the engine because these things run for very long periods of time between overhauls.
There's some footage of a single stage power turbine rotor being balanced on our balance machine.
Now, I wasn't involved in the removal or the repair of the single stage LM1500 power turbine, but I have some footage of the balancing of that, so let's take a look at that right now.
And some footage of the first stage of a two-stage power turbine being assembled with newly ceramic-coated blades.
There's the ceramic-coated blades. After all these months of waiting, go back into the beautifully clean power turbine disc. What you got for weight on there?
Let's have a look.
Some glare. Oh yeah, those are heavy.
Quite a variation too.
Hey. I'm gonna get all the footage, the before, the after, the during, the tears of joy, the tears of sorrow, the happiness, the laughter, the sadness, the crying, the despair, the weakness and the strength, for richer or poorer, till the end of time. There we have the blade locking rivets. Let's get a closer look at that. There we go.
Okay, let's compare the industrial gas generator with a modern airliner turbofan engine. It's actually very similar if you take a look. We have the compression stages of the gas generator, also called the core or the high pressure system. It's the one I'm thinking of has 15 stages of compression. I haven't drawn them all just because, well, you get the idea. It's easier to draw a simpler diagram. Then there's a hollow shaft. It connects to a two or three stage, sometimes a one stage power or turbine, a one to three stage turbine, which again drives the compressor. So this is what burns the air and turns the compressor and causes the engine to run. That's often known as the core in airliner engines. So, then we have what you could call a power turbine. It's behind the turbine, and its shaft goes through the hollow turbine, or the hollow shaft, sorry. Its shaft goes through the hollow HP shaft, all the way through the compressor, all the way to the front, to the low pressure compressor, or the fan. And the difference between a low pressure compressor and a fan is the bypass. A lot of air, let me get the blue. The air that's going to be burnt by the core does go through the fan, goes through the core, gets burnt, comes out both turbines. It's core airflow. It's air that's mixed with fuel and burnt. The fan's bypass goes around the engine. And there's a lot of it, and it really adds to the thrust. But how this is like an industrial situation is, your power turbine runs the load. The load would be the fan. Now this exact engine, we have one out there, it's the CF6. Is an LM2500. And what is an LM2500? It's the exact same thing. Let's quickly draw that. It's all the core, and then it has a power turbine right there, six stages, and its shaft goes out the back. Otherwise, it's identical. As a matter of fact, there's a, I think it's 80% parts commonality between the LM2500 and the CF6. I believe it's a 50. It's the only difference. There you go. Your power turbine drives a mechanical load in an industrial situation. In an industrial plant, the power turbine drives your mechanical load. In the airliner engine, the power turbine drives a mechanical load, which is the fan, which adds massive thrust to the engine. And they're both made by GE. They're very similar. Try to keep that a secret. Okay, there, I've finished off the diagram for you. You can see that they're extremely similar. There is no fan on the industrial gas generator, and that would be a waste, because this bypass flow is a mechanical load on the engine, and we want to use that shaft either going forward or going backwards to do some work, whether it's to drive a generator, to drive a ship. A lot of the US Navy ships hook this up to a gearbox with several LM2500s, and then they drive the prop for the ship. And with four of these engines, some of the US ships have 100,000 horsepower that can be on tap within seconds. Not bad. Okay, and let's finish off with a couple of the smaller categories of engines, but very, very important. And again, they're very similar for turbine-powered aircraft and helicopters. The turboprop has a slightly smaller version of a jet engine, gas generator, just like the big guys in the industrials. And it has a power turbine, and integral with the engine is the engine speed reduction gearbox, which reduces the speed of the power turbine, or the free power turbine. Could call it the LP turbine, but it's usually called the free power turbine. But this is one particular type of turboprop, the PT6, in general terms. So it has a free power turbine, a speed reduction gearbox, and the output to the propeller shaft is about 2200 RPM. The engine spins around 40,000 RPM. The power turbine, 30-ish, in the mid-30s. I don't know exactly, so if you know exactly, great, tell me. We don't deal with these engines all the time, so I don't know exactly what the speeds are. But that's basically it. The PT6 has a free power turbine. The other most popular turboprop engine is the Garrett TPE331, and it has the speed reduction gearbox directly mounted to the main engine shaft. There is no free power turbine. It's a different type of engine. It works great. It's just as popular. I just wanted to draw one. Okay, this is the PT6. And a helicopter engine is also very similar. Just the speeds are a little different. The gas generator section, again, 40 to 50,000 RPM. The power turbine, 30 to 40, give or take, depending on the size of the helicopter engine. There's an engine reduction gearbox, the output of which is around 6,000 RPM, roughly. Again, they differ. And that gets fed into another gearbox, which is part of the helicopter, not part of the engine. And that's main output speed varies with power turbine speed, but its maximum is usually about 400 RPM. That's the RPM of the main rotor of the helicopter. Now, smaller helicopters will turn faster, bigger ones slower. These numbers are general in terms, but you can see how all the gas turbine engine and power plant and drive systems are very closely related. So now you're an expert. Thanks.